Do you know what sort of person would kill four children?
I have no comprehension.
Folbigg was convicted in 2003 of the murders of Patrick, Sarah and Laura and the manslaughter of her firstborn, Caleb, over a 10-year period.
Folbigg has spent 19 years in jail with at least six to go, but she believes new genetic evidence could clear her name.
The Mother's Guilt podcast looks at one of Australia's most compelling criminal cases, that of a mother convicted of smothering her four infant children over two decades ago. Kathleen Folbigg was described as Australia's worst serial killer and Australia's most hated woman once she was found guilty of three counts of murder and one of manslaughter in 2003. The four infants died between 1989 and 1999. Caleb died at 19 days of age. Patrick died at 8 months, Sarah died at 10 months of age, and Laura died just shy of 19 months of age. Now, the Crown argued that Miss Folbigg found her children an irritant. That's why she smothered them. They got in the way of her social life, going to the gym and getting a good night's sleep. But what if the courts got it wrong two decades ago? Scientists now believe two of the children, the two girls, Laura and Sarah, died of an inherited genetic mutation that's linked to sudden cardiac arrest and death in infants. This finding throws the entire case against Kathleen Folbigg into reasonable doubt. The Mother's Guilt podcast traces the case back to 1967 when Kathleen was born into a family full of domestic violence, and such a tragic start to her life is traced. Then we go through her childhood and we meet her school friends, who tell us of a very different Kathleen Folbigg than the one that was presented in court. I speak with school friends Tracy Chapman, Billy Joe Bradshaw and Negan Donegan, and they draw us a picture of a young Kathleen. With a lack of forensic evidence to support smothering the four children, the case largely was circumstantial and relied on the idea that four sudden infant deaths in one family was highly unusual and therefore suspicious. They also used Kathleen Folbigg's private diary entries to paint a picture of a woman guilty. Now, almost 20 years on, scientists have discovered the two daughters, Sarah and Laura, inherited a genetic mutation on a gene that's linked with cardiac arrhythmias and sudden death. The science is so compelling that 151 eminent scientists from around the world have now signed a petition to pardon Kathleen Folbigg, and that's why a new inquiry has been called to hear the new evidence in mid-November 2022. I speak with legal expert Dr. Robert Moles, who argues if two of the children died of natural causes, the whole case against Kathleen Folbigg falls over. He likens the case to Lindy Chamberlain, who was infamously jailed in the 1980s for killing her own baby daughter, Azaria, who she always claimed was taken by a dingo. I also speak to the geneticist, Professor Peter Botcher, whose forensic evidence is what helped Lindy Chamberlain get cleared of all convictions. He knows that science can get it wrong and the law can get it wrong. And he's one of the signatories to the petition to release Kathleen Folbigg.
Ms. Folbigg should be out of prison. And it is important that she be declared not guilty.
Over eight episodes, the Mother's Guilt podcast examines the new science, tests the original case with experts in the field, and examines the diaries in depth. I hope you enjoy it.